The Supreme Court will get the final word in a battle over Michigan's ban on affirmative action in college admissions. A court of appeals struck it down as unconstitutional. But state attorney Bill Schuette appealed, and now the nation's highest court will hear the case, even though a decision is already pending on a similar challenge in Texas. 7 Action News legal analyst Tom Cranmer joins us tonight to break it all down for us. Well, thanks, Tom, for joining us, as always, to talk about this controversial issue, to say the least. So now the Supreme Court has decided to not just hear the Texas case on affirmative action in college admissions, but the Michigan case as well. So what does this really mean for us?
Well, I think it means for us is that we're going to be at the table. We're going to be part of what I think is going to be a very significant United States Supreme Court decision. And what they're deciding really is the issue of whether or not affirmative action is something that can and should be considered in college admissions. You recall that back in 2006, the Michigan voters passed a constitutional amendment essentially saying, no, it should not be part of the admissions process. But that constitutional amendment was challenged. It was challenged in federal court. And the Court of Appeals, the Sixth Circuit, said, no, that amendment is unconstitutional. And now the U.S. Supreme Court will have to weigh in on that.
And you believe if they come back, whether they ban affirmative action in college admissions or they keep it in place, this will not only affect Texas and Michigan, but really the entire country?
Well, I think so. Generally, the types of cases that the U.S. Supreme Court takes on are cases that have a broad impact, a broad significance. And I think their ruling would impact not only, obviously, universities here in the state of Michigan, but also across the country as well.
Do you think they'll rule on this pretty quickly, or this is going to be?
Well, it probably will be decided, as they say, in the term coming up, but it'll be a number of months before we'll actually have a decision from the court. But it'll certainly be one that's going to be closely watched by many, many
folks.
Yeah,
a lot of people will be waiting, and I'm sure they're going to weigh in on it as the process goes along. Thank you, Tom, for joining us, as always.
Carolyn, thank you.